got a C-minus in public speaking at UConn. Keep your marks up low and just bear with me. All right. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Ryan, and I'm Mark's first cousin. Although, based on our complexions and our body shapes, most people don't think there's any genetic link at all between the two. Here's our shirts from the bachelor party. It's a good example. I realize for most of the women, it's hard to get a chuckle at Mark's expense. But for me, it's like a 1 foot putt. Mark's clean cut. He's well mannered. He's honest to a fault. And not tonight. He's very brave for letting me get this one. So, you have to understand, Mark and I, we grew up closer than most brothers. For years, he called, texted me, emailed me incessantly, always wanted to hang out. Came over to my house at random. This all culminated in April of 2013, when we took a trip to the Masters. We had a great time, and he briefly talked about it earlier that I didn't put any credence to it. And then, when we got back from the Masters trip, suddenly, the twice weekly phone calls turned into semi-annual phone calls. And these emails became far more scarce than they ever were before. And then there was 6 months where there was just nothing at all. I'm not gonna lie, first, I pleasantly enjoyed this hiatus. But after a while, I started to have some concerns. Did Mark fall into some sort of deep, dark depression that he needed to be rescued from? Did he contract some sort of serious illness that was life-threatening? So I did a little investigating. I spoke with my friends, family. I found out he met a girl, and that she was now far more important than spending any sort of time with me. And so I figured I'd meet her, if it lasted. And then I finally met him. And I saw what Mark saw. She's an absolutely magnetic person. And so at this point, I knew there was potential for true love. So I came to accept my new role in Mark's life as part-time from full-time. And in hindsight, this is definitely for his long-term physical and mental benefit. You guys got a beautiful night tonight. Kim, you look stunning, as we always say. Your bridesmaids look absolutely gorgeous. When I heard Mark was gonna have 7 groomsmen, I wondered, did he ever make 7 friends? I knew there was gonna be a lot of digging through yearbooks, iPhone phone books. Luckily, we were able to scrap 7 of them together. And they all said yes. So, when it came to making friends, what can I say? Mark chose quality over quantity. Except for maybe Travis, who was just up here. Now, I realize there's challenging topics to go over in an interfaith marriage. So I thought to myself, you know, what can I tackle? It's about religion. That's good. We'll go with a religious story. So I went through every religious book I had, and I tried to find a story that would relate, you know, Mark's life to the religious story. And finally, I found one. It's a story that goes a little something like this. I'm sure you all know it. Follows a person on their path through life along a beach, and there's 2 sets of footprints. And at the end of the person's life, they look back, and at the hardest times, they notice there's only 1 set of footprints. So they wonder, they ask God, God, why are you not with me during these challenging times? And God says, that's when I carry you. And so, Mark's life is actually no different. I was able to follow him firsthand on his path through life. And at times on the path, there was just 1 set of footprints. So I looked and I wondered, was Mark left alone during these times? These were times that included when he got a B+ on his 5th grade book report that his parents mostly wrote for him. Yeah. by the time he was left at the bus stop for 2 minutes by himself. So his mother could make sure that there were warm cookies for him when he got home. More recently, his employer had the nerve to ask him to commute to his very own night shift. Now, Mark made it through these tough times. There he is. But looking back, did he have to do this by himself? I started looking at the footprints on the beach where there was just one set. And I started looking at them closer and closer. And I thought, does God really wear a women's 7.5? And then I found this. And I thought, it was Mark's mother who carried me through all of that. Husband for Kim. How can I be so sure of that? I can be sure of that because Mark has learned his whole life firsthand from the master of happy marriage, his father, my uncle John Gallagher. My uncle John is the happy marriage. It's kind of like what Babe Ruth is to baseball, or more so like what Warren Buffett is to investing. He's a living legend. Sage, he's sought after for his advice. He's a wealth of knowledge just waiting to be tapped. If any of you have any marital struggles, you see no prayer time, you need to come to the house. So, look, we don't have all night. We all want to eat and drink. So, I'm going to boil down the basic principles he's bestowed upon me and hopefully Mark for osmosis living with him to a little cheat sheet for Mark to make this marriage as happy as possible. So Mark, number one, Kim's always right. There's absolutely no exceptions to this rule. If she's ever wrong, it's because you had a lapse of your memory. Number two, let's say you're watching a game with your buddies. Maybe you worked a double shift and you haven't eaten in 15 hours. If Kim asks you to do something, you shut up, and you do it immediately. And you do it with a smile on your face. And now the most important thing my Uncle John has taught me, and hopefully taught Mark, is that when it comes to the biggest decisions in life, and your marriage, when to have kids, when to take an out-of-state promotion, when to buy a house, although you already did, but when to buy a house, most people are gonna say, hey Mark, go with your gut. Follow your instincts, Mark. That's totally wrong. You go with Kim's advice. Maybe it turns out that, you know, Kim's right. You praise her for her brilliance. Kim, you're amazing. Now, let's say she's catastrophically wrong. You somehow spin it to take the blame completely yourself. And you apologize profusely. Now, the more closely you follow these rules, the faster your happiness is going to multiply together. And with that, again, I'd just like to congratulate both Ruth and John Gallagher. And Ruth and Jody, both celebrating over 35 years of marriage together tonight. Big thanks to the parents again for holding the event. And guys, I wish you nothing but the best.